stars and bright stars through the perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we
RPD, with the RPD, Randy Benjamin, for helping us get this wonderful person who I've been wanting to meet for a long time. As you remember, Anthony suffered a severe gunshot wound while on duty a couple of years ago. It's been a tough, long road to recovery for Officer DiPonzio. Because of this man's great courage, he was able to go back to work a couple of days ago. Officers, everybody here this evening, that type of, what you have displayed, the same type of courage as our honored champions here this evening. You, too, are a champion. That's very, very important. And you're in our corner. We're in your corner. Keep punching, Anthony, and we're all proud of you. One other thing, and then we'll move forward. My wife files a complaint against me with the RPD because of all the boxing and Hickok belt paperwork all over the house. Take my complaint by all means, but don't file it until after Thanksgiving Day. I want that roast turkey dinner that she's famous for. One more dinner. Thank you, Chairman. God bless you. Big hand. Rocky. Chuck Wepner's documentary, of course, again, premiered on ESPN last week. I was very impressed with this film of Wepner. Did you know he had a great, great sense of humor? This is what he had to say, and he just took me back. The day, and I quote, the day of the Muhammad Ali fight, I bought my wife a powder blue negligee and told her, wear this tonight, because you'll be sleeping with the heavyweight champ of the world. That night after the bloody fight, his wife humorously busted his chops and says, do I go to his room, or will he come to mine? I'm supposed to turn this over at this time, but I remember this next guy. I'm supposed to turn this over to our master of ceremonies, Dave Earle. But you know, a few years ago, I had the opportunity to meet.
Yeah.
He was at one of the Rochester Boxing Hall of Fame banquets, and that was a great Bobby Chess, who I just admire tremendously.